Hey guys, what's up? Alec back with the daily stock market, and look at that, Unity's down 17%. So in this video, we're going to dive into Unity, see if they're a good stock to buy after selling off 17% and down 68% from the last year. We also see Redbox is down around 10%. Okay, and they're down 78% in the past month. But remember, in the last 3 months, they had an absolute explosion. So if you've been shorting Redbox stock, congratulations. Now, if we go to the top of the spectrum, we see Twitter, which we're going to be talking about in this video also in more detail, up 8% just today. So there is a lot of hot stocks moving rapidly right now. We also have Goev moving crazy amounts down intraday 10%, and then it rallied 10% right after that. And this is after being up in just the past week. They were up around 100% after inking a deal with Walmart. So make sure you stay throughout this entire video if you want updates on Goev, Twitter, Unity, and make sure you subscribe with post notifications so you don't miss out on any future uploads. So the first one we're going to talk about is Canoe, ticker symbol G-O-E-V. Okay, up significantly, just inked a deal with Walmart. I'll say this right off the bat. This is an extremely speculative play. So any money you put in to Canoe, make sure that it is disposable income. You can see they IPO'd in 2019 for around $10 per share, and they were on a straight track to success. And then ever since 2020, the end of 2020, when they were at $20 per share, they pretty much just been downhill ever since. They're at $3 per share now, losing around 80 to 90% of their value. So it's interesting, what did Walmart see in them? If we scroll down, we can see I own 100 shares at around $3.70 per share. This is an extremely speculative play. And if you want to learn a little bit more about them, you could see that Canoe Inc. manufactures electric vehicles. It designs a modular electric platform purpose built to deliver maximum vehicle interior space and adaptable to support a wide range of vehicle applications for consumers and businesses. The company was founded in 2018, and the headquarters is in Torrance, California. The listed name is Goev, is a Canoe Class A common stock. If we scroll down, we can also see that they're a not profitable company as of right now. After the Walmart deal, it might be a little bit different. They're under a $1 billion market cap, so only $900 million for their market cap. Their average volume and volume on the day is a little bit higher than the average volume, obviously because of the deal going on with Walmart. We can see that they are getting closer to profitability, and the last two quarters they have underperformed. Shares of EV maker Canoe surge after Walmart agrees to buy 4,500 delivery vans. Walmart will buy at least 4,500 and up to 10,000 of Canoe's electric delivery vans. The vans are expected to go in service 2023, and shares of Canoe actually gained more than 50% following the news. Electric vehicle startup Canoe said Tuesday Walmart has agreed to sign 4,500 of its upcoming delivery vans, and it's a significant win for the embattled vehicle maker. And you can see that Walmart agreed on this Tuesday. And if you can see this top tweet right here from Mr. Elon Musk, a week ago, he tweeted out, maybe Tesla should make a highly configurable robo van for people and cargo. So be careful. Obviously, Canoe is a speculative play because if Tesla comes in, for example, and takes market shares from GoEV, that could crush it if they end up partnering with Walmart. The reason why Walmart's even doing this in the first place is because you can see right here, the EV wars are on. It's Amazon and Rivian versus Walmart and Canoe. So Walmart, as of right now, is trying to compete with Amazon when it comes to delivery, electric vehicle delivery. So Amazon already has Rivian, we know that. Walmart didn't have anybody till just yesterday, Tuesday, and that's Canoe. So if Walmart implements Tesla, that could hurt Canoe. So overall, I think Canoe is a very, very risky play. It's one of the riskiest plays in the stock market right now. But in my opinion, it possibly could go back up to at least IPO prices in the next few months. So personally, I'm going to be playing this as a short-term swing trade. I'll probably buy 100 shares once we see Canoe go back down, because I think there's a strong probability that we will see them closer to $2.50 once again. All the hype will die down again with Canoe, in my opinion, and they probably will be going even lower. So personally, I'm staying away from this one. But if we see them under $2 per share, once again, I might just fumble around with 100 shares. It's only like $200 to risk. I'm pretty okay with that. Okay, so the next one that we have to talk about is Twitter stock, ticker symbol TWTR, at $36 per share, up 7% just on the day. And we see that Twitter is suing Mr. Elon Musk because of what's going on. He's refusing to buy him. We're going to go through a full update. And it fell around 15%. But ironically, now we're seeing they're up around 11%. So personally, I have price alerts set between $30 per share and $33 per share. At that price, I'll be making another video on Twitter revisiting if I'm going to be buying. Right now, I'm not buying, but I do have those price alerts set at $30 per share. It's probably going to be a lot more attractive for me to buy at $30 per share, but I think there's even possibilities of it even going lower with all the drama going on with Mr. Elon Musk right now. There's probably no point in getting in Twitter unless it sells off drastically, just because of the risk versus reward on Twitter as of right now. Personally, if Mr. Elon Musk does end up buying Twitter, I would want to be a part of that company, because I think if Mr. Elon Musk ends up buying Twitter, I think he can rally it to new all-time highs and get a lot of the community behind it, get a lot of new excitement behind it. And I personally like investing in CEO-led companies. Okay, so I think they could go around $60, $70 per share again, which would be around 100% increase from current price if Elon Musk does buy it. However, we'll probably get the news late, and by the time we already know if Elon Musk does buy Twitter, it would probably already have rallied 20% in one day off just the news. So with that being said, $20 per share. We have a five-year low of around $15 per share. I doubt it could get that low again. But $25 per share, $30 per share are important price targets that I have set. If you guys don't use Twitter, by the way, Elon Musk is hilarious on Twitter. And also give me a follow on Twitter at the Daily Stock Market. The sign is actually, the at sign is TDSM stocks. So TDSM is obviously for the Daily Stock Market stocks, TDSM stocks, to find me there. But going back to Mr. Elon Musk, let's see what his new one about Joe Biden was. A little bit of a low blow, but it was pretty funny. Let's see. This is the one that we want to talk about. They said I couldn't buy Twitter. Then they wouldn't disclose the bot info. So if you guys don't know, he didn't end up buying Twitter because he said that there was 20% bots on Twitter, and Twitter claims there's only like 3% or less than 5% bots, which he doesn't agree with. And it says now they want me to force me to buy Twitter in court. Now they have to disclose their bot info in court. So to simplify what that means, basically he's going to get a huge haircut because Twitter is going to be forced to report that they have around 20% bots as their user base. So instead of buying Twitter at around $54 per share, because remember that was the original price that Mr. Elon Musk and Twitter agreed on, was $54 per share, he'll probably get a huge haircut and he'll probably get Twitter for around $30 per share if it ends up going through court. This is probably going to be a long drawn out process, could take 6-12 months for him to eventually buy Twitter. And by that time, Twitter could be beaten down to around our $25 price target. So here, that's why you're seeing a lot of articles right now that are saying Twitter sues Elon Musk to force him to complete acquisitions. Twitter has sued billionaire Elon Musk in an effort to force him to follow through with his deal to buy social media company at $54 per share. The lawsuit filed in Delaware court, blah, 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 on Tuesday comes after Musk said in a letter to Twitter's top lawyer late Friday that he wants to terminate the blockbuster $44 billion acquisition agreement. And today you can actually see that market cap on Twitter is closer to $28 billion. Just by siding on that dotted line, he would be losing around $15 billion of market value. Musk's lawyers alleged in Friday's letter that Twitter is in a material breach of multiple provisions of the deal, claiming the company has withheld data Musk's requested in order to evaluate the number of bots and spam accounts on the platform. Twitter's legal team hit back in a letter on Monday, calling Musk's attempt termination invalid and wrongful, claiming that Musk himself had violated the agreement and demanding that he'd follow through with the deal. So you can see it's just a lot of back and forth that's going to have to be solved in court. Elon's probably going to get a big discount, I think. It seems like as of right now, he's not going to buy Twitter. But if he does buy Twitter, I think he's going to get a huge discount. And I think at the end of the day, that's why he's doing all this, is so he can get a lot better of a discount. Instead of getting, you know, acquiring Twitter at $44 billion market cap, he could get probably a $20 billion haircut if he proves those bots are around 20% of Twitter's platform, which I think he has a great chance to do. However, it could take a long time. So that's why right now I'm leaving Twitter stock alone. And the last one that we'll talk about is Unity Software, ticker symbol U, down to 17.5% on the day. Absolutely obliterated. You can see it's been trading through this channel for about the last 2 months, going as low as $30 per share and as high as $45 per share. So right now it seems like that $30 support is holding up pretty good. So we'll also see that next month on the 9th, they're expected to report earnings after hours. They're a non-profitable company, and for the last 4 quarters, they've slightly beat estimates every single time. Their revenue is where they shine. Their net income is where they need to get profitable at. Their PE ratio is obviously not profitable, but their revenue does look pretty good, growing around 20% per year. Okay. Now their market cap is around $10 billion. And if you don't know what they do, Unity Software develops video game software. It provides software solutions to create, run, and monetize interactive real 2D and 3D content for mobile phones, tablets, PCs, consoles, and augmented and virtual reality devices. The firm operates as a platform for creating and operating real-time 3D content, and it was founded by two guys in 2004 and is headquartered in San Francisco, California. If we dive a little bit deeper, we can see that Unity shares are down 13% on lowered 22 guidance merger agreement with IronSource. Unity shares sank in pre-market Wednesday after it announced merger agreement with IronSource and lowered its 2022 guidance. Shares of Unity fell roughly 15% and are down 72% year to date. Iron Surge, however, surged 50%. In tandem with the merger announcement, Unity also reduced full year 2022 guidance, which is never a good thing. Okay, we already went over that. In tandem with the merger, Unity reduced its full 22 guidance from $1.35 billion to $1.42 billion to $1.3 billion to $1.35 billion. Okay, which isn't the biggest deal, honestly. They raised it and then they lowered it, citing the macroeconomic environments and competitive dynamic and monetizing. Shares of Unity are down 76% year to date. IronSource, valued at $4.4 billion, will merge into a wholly owned subsidiary of Unity via an all-stock deal. Each ordinary share of IronSource will be exchanged for 0.1089 shares of Unity common stock. Okay, after the deal completes, Unity's stockholders will roughly own 73% of the combined company, and current IronSource shareholders will keep about 26% of the company. And up to $2.5 billion share buyback program will be in effect when the transaction is closed, Unity said. The combination of Unity and IronSource better supports creators of all size, which is important, by giving them all the tools they need to create and grow successful apps and gaming and other consumer-facing verticals like e-commerce, said the CEO of Unity. This is a step further towards realizing our vision of fully integrated platform that helps creators in every step of their real-time 3D journey, which is super bullish for long-term. You can see that they acquired 73% of this company. However, the shares are down 13%. And obviously, the reason why the shares are down 13% is not because it acquired 73% of a company, which is a good thing for long-term. It's because of the adjusted downward guidance for 2022. Nobody likes adjusted downward guidance, but you can see they started at 1.35 and then they raised it to 1.42, then they lowered it and then they raised it again to 1.35. So we're pretty much back to where we started anyway, which isn't a huge deal, I think. So overall, if you want to diversify yourself into the metaverse, if you want to be a part of a huge growth stock that could 5 to 10x, but remember, this with anything that sounds good like that is going to offer huge risks. So anytime you hear growth and 500% gains and 5x, 10x, you're just understand and realize the risks involved with Unity software. Also, this is more of a speculative play. There's no guarantee that Unity software is the one that takes off. However, they have a lot of great video games behind its belt already. If you guys want to dive in a little bit deeper on your own time, that's awesome also. But some top games made with Unity: Fall Guys, Among Us, Cuphead, Pokemon Go, Beat Saber, and here are some other ones: Rust. If you heard of Unreal Engine, Unity Software is pretty similar to them. The way that Unity Software stands out, however, is they're more for the beginner person that's looking into develop games for the first time. It's a lot more accessible to beginners, where Unreal Engine is more professional and advanced. Okay, so with that being said, I'm dollar cost averaging, not a lot, but close to that $30 mark as possible, or under $30 mark, I think is pretty attractive from a growth speculative standpoint. Obviously, I don't make my speculative positions larger than 1 to 2% of my portfolio diversity. But real quick, if we look at the balance sheet on Unity, it's actually low risk of going out of business. You can see that there's 52% liabilities assets, which is good. The total current assets are $2.2 billion. Cash and cash equivalents and with short-term investments is $1.8 billion. Okay, so remember that, $1.8 billion. If we scroll down to total liabilities, we can actually see it's $2.5 billion. So not only can they easily pay off their total liabilities with their total assets and their total current assets, but if we look at their total current liabilities, it's only $630 million, and their cash alone, just their cash, is $1.1 billion, which is easy for them to pay off. Not a lot of risk of going out of business with this company. As you can see, they are a revenue monster, doing $320 million. Per quarter in revenue. If we pull out to annual, we can see that they do $1.1 billion annually in total revenue, and they've been growing around 40% in revenues every single year. I think earlier in this video I said 20%. They've actually been growing 40% year over year in revenue. Their income, obviously we need work on that. We've been losing more. We're now a $500 million unprofitable company. So again, we need to see this company closer to profitability. This is why it's a speculative play. We don't know if it can get closer to profitability, because from 2018, it's only been getting worse and worse and worse over the last 4 years since it's been a public company, which is not a good sign. So that's why I don't want to put too much money in them, but I do want to play my chips on Unity Software. This is more of a gamble stock, but over the next 1 to 2 years, if they start becoming more and more profitable and get more and more game engines under their belt, if they get the average person developing games on their platform, I think it can become a more profitable company. So overall, not putting a lot of money on Unity, just because the risks versus reward, the risks are a little bit higher, and I think there's better deals to put your money in the stock market compared to Unity. So I hope you guys really appreciated that video. Take a second out of your day, smash a thumbs up on this video, and share with a friend if you think that they will find it beneficial. Also, if you want to see some success stories that all my students have been having, we now have over 1,500 students in the program signed up with over 500 positive testimonials. And we just had some crazy results in the close friends list just today. So if you go on my story, you actually don't even have to go on the highlight. But if you just go on the actual story, you can see that many results have been taking place. Made around 320% myself. Some other students have made over 80%, 132% gains. $125 just took profits to play it safe. We also talk about the best time to take profits in the close friends list, accepting a few more people, shutting down signups soon. So yes, I am going to be shutting down signups soon. If you've been wanting to get on the program and make some money with options, put options, betting on the stock market going down, not only that, but we buy stocks for long term, buying the dip, finding unvalued stocks right now in the stock market, and I'm posting all my buys and sells. Reach out to me on Instagram. I'm shutting down signups soon, and then that way we'll have a wait list after that. So if you've been wanting to get on, now is definitely the time to buy the dip, find some undervalued stocks, and also bet on the stock market going down. So message me on Instagram. Other than that, make sure you subscribe with post notifications on, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Remember, don't time the market, buy the market. Peace.